It has been 1 year since a deadly attack on the U.S. Capitol, and many questions remain about the day and the days leading up to it, including what went wrong. We have team coverage from the Capitol tonight. Eric Rosales takes a look at lawmakers' reaction 1 year later, but we start with White House correspondent Owen Jensen as the president and vice president headed to the Capitol this morning. Owen.
Tracy, good evening to you. In his speech here at the Capitol today, President Biden did not mention former President Trump by name. But President Biden made it very clear who he believes is responsible for what happened here 1 year ago today.
He's not just a former president. He's a defeated former president.
President Joe Biden comes out swinging against former President Donald Trump.
And because his bruised ego matters more to him than our democracy or our Constitution, he can't accept he lost.
President Biden says President Trump spread a web of lies about the 2020 presidential election.
There is simply zero proof the election results are inaccurate. In fact, in every venue where evidence had to be produced, an oath to tell the truth had to be taken, the former president failed to make his case.
President Biden saying democracy was attacked 1 year ago when an angry mob stormed the Capitol.
This wasn't a group of tourists. This was an armed insurrection. They weren't looking to uphold the will of the people. They were looking to deny the will of the people.
Former President Donald Trump canceled his planned press conference today, instead issuing a statement saying President Biden used my name today to try to further divide America. This political theater is all just a distraction for the fact Biden has completely and totally failed. But President Biden says efforts to deny the truth of what happened on January 6th are an affront to those who defended the Capitol. More than 100 officers were injured.
How dare anyone diminish, belittle, or deny the hell they were put through.
The investigation into the attack on the Capitol is the largest in the Justice Department's history. More than 700 people have been arrested, and 350 others are still being sought by the FBI. Vice President Kamala Harris praised the heroism of the Capitol Police and others who pushed back against the rioters,
including those who later succumbed to wounds, both visible and invisible.
The vice president saying, "We must unite in defense of our democracy."
The American spirit is being tested.
Now, after his speech today, the president, President Biden, was asked why he did not mention President Trump directly by name in his speech. And the president said he did not want to make it about himself or the vice president, and he did not want to turn it into a contemporary political battle, in his words. At the Capitol, Owen Jensen, EWTN News Nightly.